now let's come to know, what should I do? I want this work now, okay? I want to have international business law related work. काम तो करना है. क्या चाहिए उसके लिए?
आप बताइए. Let's pause for a bit and ask everybody कि क्या करना चाहिए. We have already
discussed. What skills do you
need? What skills do you need?
This is where we are coming to Labdhi. Training sources. We are coming to that. So what skills do you need? Yeah, yes, knowledge, but knowledge. What kind of? It's a very generic statement. Quick network building. Okay. Will international moot court competitions help?
Then we will tell you. We will tell you how they will help.
Perfect knowledge of law.
Nobody has perfect knowledge of law, people. You need good knowledge of law.
License to practice, not in all situations. You think Rajdeep has, Rajpreet has license to practice in Germany and US? Not in all cases. You don't need that. Okay. Drafting skills and knowledge of international laws. Well, yeah, it is there. How is law interpreted in different countries? First of all, what are the laws in different countries? That's what you need to know, isn't it? So let's reveal it now, Yash. What do they need?
Yeah, I think we should start now on this.
So what are the technical skills you need? Okay, we are going to look at what is technical. This is the thing, strategy. You should know how to frame. Okay. From planning, so you are selecting a country where someone will go, where someone will foray, the business structure that they will adopt, what is IP protection, and right down to the enforcement stage if there is an issue. So you must also know ki if the money is locked there, money paisa fas gaya, to kaise nikalna hai, okay? How do you recover that? Okay, and then the dispute resolution mechanisms for sure. यहाँ पे पीपल फाइंड डिफिकल्टी टू गेट इन टू द जोन ऑफ मनी रिकवरी. यू विल हैव टू नो दिस. नेगोशिएशन स्किल्स, ब्रिलियंट नेगोशिएशन स्किल्स. सो लॉयर्स एंड सीएस कैन ब्रिज द गैप बिटवीन इन्वेस्टर्स एंड बिजनेस एडवाइजर. दिस इज ह्यूज बिकॉज वी आर सेइंग दैट पीपल हु विल इन्वेस्ट इन दिस काइंड ऑफ कंपनीज, ओके, and the business advisors in other countries, you have to be someone who's able to negotiate that, okay, so that the business whom you are advising is able to earn really well, okay, and you have to negotiate terms and conditions in such a manner with the investor and with the advisor in both the cases, okay, so that you are able to get the objective and you are able to get the benefit, the business is able to get the benefit. Drafting and reviewing skills, inevitable. So, you know, you have to have the ability to draft the transaction documents and understand the implications of the terms while reviewing them. Now, you will be working on contracts where one party will be Indian, one party will be out of India. Okay? And you have to think of implications in that case. Liaisoning skills, you will have to work with regulators in foreign jurisdictions. You will have to work. You will have to work with the government to get the entity, get licenses on time when you want to work. Okay. So when the business wants to get into a start something very specific and you are required to get the approval from the government, this is something that will come to your help.
For example, suppose you're advising somebody who is entering into a different country, a food business, say they manufacture chips. So what kind of regulators on top of your head can you think of they will be looking for? Give at least 2 to 3 examples that if you're advising somebody, then who are the regulators for entering Germany they will be looking for?
Food quality, like FSSAI.
Very good.
What else?
That reminds me, if you know, Haldiram was penalized heavily because because I think they had too many spices by a food regulator in US. So that kind of challenges you have. Other than food regulation authority.
Other than that, what else? Packaging. Okay.
Amazing.
Mental health standards.
Very good, Sneha. Very good.
Brilliant.
Brilliant. That's okay. Like really something which nobody thinks of immediately.
Yeah. Trade
regulation.
You have to find out, you will have to know what works in that. For example, let's go into this. For example, in US, let's say suppose it's in some state you are in existence. Where do you have to go if you want to incorporate an entity? What is the office you have to go to? Anyone is aware? What is the office in US? Like how we have a registrar of companies here. Okay. Whom do we have to go to? SEC? Really?
I know about the UK. Who is going to tell
us? Who is in UK? Okay, tell.
Monish. Monish knows about the UK. Tell us, Monish.
What is the place where you incorporate a company in UK, Monish? Yeah, it is the company's house, okay. Correct.
Very good.
It's called company's house, correct. So in US, guys, it is the respective secretaries of states, okay, that you approach to approach for the purposes of starting or incorporating an entity in that place, okay? So like this, you will have to know what is a relevant regulator. You have to understand the legal system of different countries. You have to know how to find, read and interpret law. So Abhi, like how we said, Germany and food business. Okay. You will say US and tech business. Okay. You will say UK and let's say you want to start a restaurant there. Okay. Or let's say it's Singapore and you want to have a telecom related company there. Then how are you going to go about it? So you will have to know the legal system and the different regulators. Litigation skills. Yeah. So you have to understand how the enforcement works, okay? In different jurisdictions, what will you do if there are disputes, if somebody initiates legal action against you? Interpretation skills, this is very much essential, and I'll tell you how. Like if you are looking at DTAAs and if you're looking to take the benefit of foreign tax credit, you must be able to make sense of DTAA very, very well, because the way it works is first you pay tax in both the jurisdictions and then you take a credit of it. So you must be very clear that I am going to get credit of this. And that's how you shape your transaction. Okay?
And bahut simple si cheez hai na, ki if you're working or advising on some other country, a lot of regulations will be there, jahan pe you will find very less precedence, jo naye laws aayenge. So you need to know how that has to be interpreted. You need to be able to read the law. So that is why this is a very important skill. Aur usse pata hai kya hoga, when you have read different laws, like for instance, food regulation laws of different countries, your interpretation skill, even when you will apply to India, will be so sharp because you know this is so different than other laws.
Yes. The way you read things after that will unbelievably change, because when, and this happens, I can tell you this is a personal experience, that when you are reading things or law, immediately it will strike ki ye nahi hai yahan pe. So you immediately notice a gap that is there, and that is something which is really valuable. You notice that this is not covered or this is not, you know, used. Very quickly you notice this. Soft skills. Networking and marketing skills. Yes, you have to develop your own social media presence. Now, how do you think, you know, people actually generate and create clients? I mean, unless you have that kind of a presence and you have, see, if you don't have anything, you don't know anything in another country, how will you locate people in that country? You will go to the legal 500 list. You will see that which blog or which people are followed the most, who is listening to their advice the most. Okay. So this is where you will come to, like, you know, where you are not. And same way people will do this. Okay. So if someone is looking for people who has multi-jurisdictional skills in India, then they will see who is present there, who is visible. Someone who is not visible will not, like, you know, work at all. So professional communication skills, it's incredibly important, because in international business, there are real cultural issues. You're working with people of a completely different country. You will have to know, you know, this kind of communication skills. By the way, let's put this, like, how many of you have people, like, have interacted with people and social media or whatever, interacted with people in other countries? How many of you interacted? And this can be in lots of different ways. Many people have interacted with people in other countries. Is there a difference in how things work, the way they talk, the way they, you know, communicate? Much different from what you do in India. Very different, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Because before your law, this comes first. सबसे पहला, this my senior used to say, कि तुम्हारा law और ये सारी चीजें ना बहुत बाद में आने वाली है. तुम client ना will judge you in first 10 minutes, the way you can talk, whether you are an intelligent person or not, how you speak things.